Welcome to this webinar. My name is Kari Simolin. I am Product Manager for Panel and Stack Handling Systems and Finishing Lines in Dieffenbacher, as well as the Managing Director of Dieffenbacher's daughter company, Dieffenbacher Panel Board Oy in Finland. Today I will introduce you our latest development of stack storage systems, our new wireless STS system. With STS storage, we mean the storage where the stacks are typically approximately 4 meters high and weigh, until today, up to 60 tons. The new wireless STS takes this system to a completely new level, both in technology as well as in performance. It brings several great benefits to its users. As we feed the power to satellites with power rails and data with wireless Ethernet, and not by cable through cable trams, we increase the reliability of the system and reduce the amount of maintenance needed. Eliminating the cable trams brings several other benefits. The height of the structures can be lower, the satellites can be fed with more power, leading to a higher maximum loads and speeds. But most interestingly, the satellites can operate in the storage independent from the main wagon. All the machines of the systems has been newly designed with the principle that delivery of the machines is possible using standard containers. But it doesn't stop here. The storage area of the new STS system can be built with a glulam beam structure. This reduces the cost of the investment and, very importantly, reduces the carbon footprint of the construction. Let us look at the system in detail. The new wireless STS system consists of a main wagon, satellite wagons, storage area, and connection to production lines. The main wagon moves the stacks and satellite wagons crosswise in the storage area. The data transmission to the wagon is done by a reliable optical data link, and power is fed to wagon with power rails. Optionally, the main wagon can have the chain conveyor built into it. Later we shall see what possibilities this brings. Like said before, also main wagon is of completely new innovative design. By installing additional support wheels to the middle section of the wagon, the storage can be built to a very low structure and can be transported to customers in two halves in standard containers. The low height of a structure means that the rails in the storage area do not need to be on as high level as before, and thus less concrete filling is required for the storage area. Let us then look at the satellite wagons of the new wireless STS system. Until today, in all STS systems in the market, the power to satellites, and in most cases also data like Profibus communication, has been done with a cable and cable tram. A cable tram has been installed on the satellite and the other end of the cable to the main wagon. This cable and cable tram causes most of the issues of the old STS systems and requires a lot of regular maintenance and service. The cable has also limited the length of the STS storage to approximately 70 meters. And using a cable and a cable tram has also meant that main wagon cannot move unless the satellites are on it. With the new wireless STS, these handicaps has been eliminated. Power to satellites is fed with the power rails and data is transmitted with a wireless Ethernet. This means that the length of the storage is unlimited. The satellites can operate in the storage independently and main wagon can simultaneously execute another task. And, interestingly, one main wagon can serve several pairs of satellites. This all means higher uptime, better use of the site area, higher capacity, and lower investment, especially in high-capacity plants. The power rails are fixed to the sides of the storage structures. Not only are power rails a very reliable way of power feeding, it also allows us to feed more power to the satellite. This means that we can move heavier stacks with weights up to 75 tons. We can also move the stacks faster, with even up to 50% higher lifting and transfer speeds than before. This all means higher capacity out of one system, and sometimes this can mean that two systems are not needed. That would lead to a major saving in the investment cost. Let us look at the different configurations that the new wireless STS can be built to. Case 1 is the basic configuration that we can see in many plants today. Press line outfeed and sanding line infeed have STS chain conveyors, and the main wagon does not have the chain conveyor in it. This means that satellites must run into the chain conveyors to take the stack onto or out from the main wagon. Because the new wireless STS has much higher transfer speeds than the old systems, also this case 1 gives up to 45% more capacity than old systems. Case 2 is the configuration where the main wagon has been built in chain conveyor. This means that for moving the stacks from press line to main wagon and from main wagon to the sanding line infeed, just conveyors are needed. This is faster than using satellites for it, and approximately up to 12% more capacity can be achieved than in this basic configuration that we saw before. The new wireless STS allows totally new configuration possibilities. Like said before, the main wagon and satellites can operate independently in the storage, and main wagon can serve two or more pairs of satellites. This brings us to a case 3. Here we saw one main wagon with two pairs of satellites. The main wagon has the chain conveyor in it. This configuration gives more than double capacity compared to basic configuration. It also gives totally new layout opportunities and gives a chance to use building area more efficiently. It can reduce the investment cost significantly, especially in the high capacity plants. Let us look how it works. Here you can see that two satellite pairs are in storage and the main wagon is fetching the stack from the press line. At the same time, the sanding line needs a stack. The other pair can simultaneously fetch a stack if it is on the correct row. Immediately when the other pair of satellites have taken the stack from the main wagon can move and take the stack to the sanding line. Of course, you see it here accelerated, but still it gives more than a double transfer capacity compared to traditional configurations. And all this is possible due to the use of the power rails for feeding the power to the satellites and communicating wireless to the satellites. Let us now look at the new way of building the storage area. Traditionally, the storage supports have been built of concrete or as steel beam structures. The new way to do this is by use of glulam beams. Glulam is glued laminated timber and is meant for structures where high bending strength and long support distances are needed. It fits well for the constructing the storage area with the new wireless STS. Glulam structures give good support for the stacks and decrease the surface pressure and especially the pressure peaks near to the beam edges. It thus reduces the deformation of the panels during the storing process. Not only that the glulam beam structure is technically good, but it also reduces significantly the carbon footprint of the construction. if only materials and fabrication of material is considered, the carbon footprint is reduced by 34% compared to concrete structure and even 70% when compared to a steel frame structure. It also looks nice and gives a very clean image to this section of the plant. Like I earlier explained, the new main wagon is built in such way that distance from wagon rails to the rails of the storage area can be less, and thus the height of the concrete filling is less. New satellite wagons have also lower height than the old ones. This means that the whole structure can be lower than before. This all reduces investment cost and carbon footprint of the construction. Like the other machines of the new wireless STS, also the chain conveyor is a new design. It has a very efficient planetary gear drives, and being a modular structure, it can be transported to the site in standard containers. Essential part of the new wireless STS is the automation. I would now like to ask the manager of our automation team, Jarno Hansola, to give us a brief on how the automation of the new STS is done. Welcome, Jarno.
Thank you, Kari. Automation concept of our new wireless STS is built on the latest technologies as the other areas of the Dieffenbacher plant. These include Ethernet-based field bus, intelligent sensors, and the newest generation of PLC controllers with integrated safety features. Higher level control of storage tasks is realized by our storage management system, which is operated via the Dieffenbacher Pro Guide HMI with its standard alarming and trending features. System includes the SQL database, which allows long-term data management and comprehensive reporting. This PC-based system handles task management and communicates tasks to storage PLCs. In the wireless STS storage, we have one main PLC and PLCs in every satellite wagon. This allows satellite pair to realize individual tasks. Key feature of the automation is of course wireless communication. The main PLC communicates with satellites via VLAN network and with main wagon via optical link. The satellite pair communicates with each other with Profinet over Bluetooth technology. It should be highlighted that we have divided wireless communication to time-critical and not critical communication. Communication between satellites is fast, but due to being a task-based system, communication via VLAN does not have to be that fast. To ensure error-free operation, the storage VLAN is hidden from other VLAN devices and uses 5 GHz frequency. Also, the VLAN network is always designed according to your storage layout.
Thank you very much, Jarno. This all is the new wireless STS. We are very excited about this system. At the time of this webinar, already 11 systems have been sold to several customers around the world. We hope that you enjoyed the webinar. We look forward to your questions anytime. You may contact us or your closest Dieffenbacher representative. Thank you for being with us and see you next time.